What's up, everybody? Crimson Raven here, and it is time for part two of our Menzi run with Menzi the Shaman. So far, we are at almost 750,000 points. Time to start floor four. What do we have? We're getting Asheron's Cube. So I'm getting my favorite weapon in the game right now. One of my favorite weapons in the game. I have to say, I have a little soft spot in my heart for the Staff of Atlantis as well. So this is fun for me. This is very fun for me. Get rid of the Darren. Yo. Many cubes. We should all die. Thank you. That's a lot of poison. I'm gonna grab some sort of mana. It's gonna help a lot. Run. I'm gonna level up as well. That is a 50% damage boost, but that would mean sacrificing my favorite weapons. And it consumes them, it doesn't replace them. So if I had that on floor 1 or 2, maybe. Not now. Not torture, so I'm getting Avarice. Or Avarice. I don't freaking know how to pronounce this. Alright. Switch. Things run. Wait for that one set. One last minion. The green carrot is just standing there. Troubling. Wait, oh, it's stuck in a wall. Ew. Okay. So it got an unlucky spawn and spawned into a wall. Sure. Secrets in here, it seems. Let's go check the other side before we move on. Nothing there, nothing there. Moving on. Next room, what do we have? Teeny tiny, teeny small room. Okay, time for the cube. Well, maybe not. Man up right. Kill. That was purely bloodlust. Bloodlust is the only thing that made me survive this room, or at least that made me get out of this room with this much health. There was a lot of eyeballs in there. Very happy I took blood last. Alright, what do we got on the other side here? Okay, slimes. just gonna throw a cube over there. Oh, there's bugs on there as well. That is a lot less fun. Plus three, still for survival. Now the bones up there are starting to show up. At least I can kind of burst it down really quickly. I do a lot of damage with this thing. I like it. I like it a lot. Another summoner there. As I said before, it's a fire shotgun, so you gotta be close range. It's kinda risky, but thanks to the fact that I have Bloodlust Curse. Ah, shit. Wet floor. I hate wet floor. Even the stairs are wet. That's kinda. That makes sense. Oh, that's a lot of golems. Have some cubes. Oh, that's bad. Actually, that was pretty good. They were all in a nice big line. As well take advantage of the extra top speed I have. Still at 115 health, so looking good, but still kind of scared though. I'm taking a lot of damage. I'm not going to be able to run. I'm not going to be able to take advantage of Bloodlust all that much for the final boss. And even for this one, that's the demon boss, I'm pretty sure. Bastion, I think he's called? Yeah. It's the demon boss, and he's a freaking pain in the ass. So I'm going to really make sure that I burst him down. Massive. Your attacks do not use up mana. Okay, so cubes everywhere. Infinite mana until hit. Even better. Recover some health and energy. Okay, sure. I just sacrificed some health, so that's perfect. Considering what I have right now. For your next combat, your attacks do not use up mana. I have infinite mana for the next fight. Plus another infinite mana stacked on top of that until I get hit. But I have infinite mana for the next fight. So the next fight is going to be the boss fight. So I can just burst him down. It's either going to be one of those. And I'm just, you know, pop the amulet and burst him down. Go. I don't even have the key. Shit. I don't even have the key. Fuck. Okay. So I gotta find the key. I'm just gonna go take a look. see if the key is one of these two rooms here. Not this one. Or else it would show on the map. Not this one either. So I gotta go through one more fight. Shit. I might as well go through the small one. Gamble on the fact that there's gonna be less enemies. Ah shit, I got hit. I still got infinite mana, but that's because of the other thing that I got. I'm cubing it up. Alright. There's some XP here. The key's over here, so I actually kind of took the right way. Just... I'm still full health, full mana, and my amulet's completely charged. So again, I think the good strategic decision is gonna be for me to clear out the boss fight right now. Because I don't think I'm gonna be getting a better situation for it. Alright, Bastion. Yep. The High Priest. First him down. Die faster. Die faster. Die faster. There we go. That certainly was fast enough. I'm back to full health. And full mana. And I gotta level up. Bloodlust 4? Or Scaredy Cat? Your speed is heavily increased for a while when hit. Could be useful for running away, but I can't run away from fights. And that, I don't have a lot of mana, so I can't really go for mana burst as much as I'd want to. I'm not gonna do that. My weapons already do a lot of damage, so I'm gonna go for Bloodlust. So now if I have anything good that comes up alongside Bloodlust, I'm gonna take the other thing. Bloodlust 4 is a lot of sustain. And I don't think I'm going to be needing more than that, considering that I also have Warcry, which gives me health back at the beginning of each fight. Okay. Alright. Yeah, sure. Shield boss. Shield. Carrots. God fucking damn it, I hate carrots. Have a cube. Have another cube. Have more cubes. Okay, he's dead. That one's gone. Now he is. Have a cube. Nice and effective. That works. Next. Oh, that's bad. Run. God for Bloodlust. That just brought me back to full health. And the freaking explosive carrots, especially in a smaller room like this. this can be a friggin' nightmare to deal with. Asheron's Cube, that clears out a room very quickly. It does use up a lot of mana, though. I'm hoping that I can get some form of either mana pool upgrade, like I had for my stack, or some regen, like I have for my spell. And I know I could have taken the regen instead of Bloodlust. I didn't know. That is a lot of shockwave. I don't like it. I don't like it at all. Now, now. Ooh. Oh, it's Soul Sip. Okay. Sacrifice 66% of my health to reduce the duration of battles by 20%. I've got two questions here. Does that include boss fights? And is it 66% of my max health or my current health? I think it's my current health. And if it's my current health, then I think I can afford it, because I'm going to get it all back from Warcry and from Bloodlust. I'm gonna try it. Screw that. I'm trying it. So, okay, so it is my current health. Should be shorter. From what I've read on the card, at least. And I finished the fight with more health than I was at when I did take that perk. So, yeah, Bloodlust is really helping me recover here. Unless you're in one of those games. In that case, Bloodlust is useless, but usually there's something good at the end of those. I'll try it. That. Up. Oh, shit. Okay. Second try? Starts moving. Oh, that was close. Very close. Got a perk and a gun. Telekinetic, sure. Magma Blaster. Hell no, I'm keeping the cube. Side jump, there we go. I can just jump that from here. Okay. That is a lore scroll room. potato. Yes, so it is an ode. A poem. Dedicated to the spud. Why the hell not? And that is it for 4-4. So it's time to go down to the final floor. Bastion's already dead, so I can just run. Be able to burst him down like I did. No. Atlantis staff is too good for me to switch. So just gonna go my way. I could go Bloodlust 5, but I'm back to full health already. I'm gonna go for magic missile for him. Something in there that was an orange crystal. Nothing here. I'm gonna go check at the other end just in case for secret rooms. There is a secret room. Oh, good God. My meta usage on this thing is atrocious. Oh, that'll help it. Okay. Okay, I still have to wait for it to recharge after 4 shots, but it's going to recharge faster. Significantly faster, actually. No, that way. Thank you. That was more of an annoyance than anything else. I'm out of mana though, but it was too bad. I've been getting... It's been, what, like the third Juggernaut move I've been getting? That is a massive annoyance. I'm doing a lot of damage. Solar thing. I don't go very bad. Storm Amulet. I'm gonna keep the one I have. It's gonna be... The amulet I currently have is gonna be of much more use for the boss fight, for the final boss, than the Storm one. The Storm one could help me clear, though. I'm regenerating that mana, that green mana, and it's going to use Windows green mana usage in exchange. I get max health increased. Even better. Yes, I like that. And the last one. Receive more damage, but you get more XP from knowledge gems. Ooh, that one I don't like at all. I already do. I already get plenty of XP. Oh, demons! Freeze a demon. Yes. Hide. Stay in cover. There we go. Didn't have a lot of cover, but it was enough. Shoot magic projectiles in a circle pattern each time you pick up crystal. I don't even know which one I picked. I mistapped on my spacebar. I think it actually... Yeah, it increased my staff mana pool. Oh well, it's the second best. Invisible enemy! You tell me where they are. Thank God for that cube. Because it can highlight, well, it can stun enemies, which is basically lowering their attack speed. And because of that... Oh, okay. Where's it coming, the next one? Right there. Shit, 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 shit. Okay, time to bounce on all of the smaller debris. Okay, so back to square one. First one goes here. Right there. Second one goes here. Oh, crap! I gotta stop hitting the freaking spacebar when I don't mean to. That one's good. Okay. Getting a bit of lag in this room. Because of the many moving parts. Then go there. Here, jump. metagems give me more energy. I'm keeping the cube, though. The cube is love, the cube is life, the cube is everything I've ever wanted. And I think I'm just gonna go here instead. Redoing the whole thing backwards. And I'm just gonna rely on bloodlust to recover my health. That is Cepheus. Not yet. I'd like to recover some health before that. Dick! Banshees, holy shit! Obliterator, revenge, or life awareness. Life awareness, definitely. The extra health will be more than welcome when I fight Cepheus. Yes, he didn't have like this one parent. That's good. Keep my eye out. Other shaman. Be pretty much full mana from just from Vigilant. Except for the green. Except for my staff, which is probably the weapon I'm the most likely to use in this situation. I've already spent everything I could here, so. Because I don't think I'm going to be able to get up close too much with Cepheus. He does a lot of damage up close. So the shotgun, I'm not going to be able to use all that much. So I'm probably going to want to burn my amulet by using a nice staff as much as possible. I don't want to go for Obliterator because my mana pools are already small enough. And I don't want to go for Alchemy Affinity because it's going to weaken my other weapons. So I have to go for one Master. Not much choice there. Even though it's noisy. No way. first one is the first one we met over there. Hi. I can even deal with him with my wand. Which is good. I want to make sure I have as much ammo as I can. Oh, that's going to be bad. Oh, I'm not going to have fun. Oh, please let me out. All the cubes. Have all the cubes. I don't care. Just die. Holy crap. Thank God for bloodlust. Again, I would be dead if not for bloodlust right now. Just from this one. I hope these damn walls won't be able to stop me now. Okay, so just books and a health potion, which is useless to me. It's time to go for Cepheus. Time to go for the boss fight. This is not going to be a stomp, but I stand a chance. I have a chance. Because of Vigilant, I should be fairly close to full mana when I start this thing. So I want to pretty much burn my whole green mana pool with the amulet as fast as I can on him, and then try to finish him off with the cube. And in the worst of cases, I'll go up close. Stamina Cepheus. Judge, jury, and executioner. Sounds about right. Okay, he's below half. Alright, going in close. And he's dead. I was able to burst him down fast enough. There are still projectiles falling around, though. I got killed once after killing Cepheus that way, just from the purple projectiles that fall over. That was probably the most frustrating thing that ever happened to me in Ziggurat. But we finished the game! We finished it. I'm gonna skip this thing. I know I'm gonna skip the credits. Sorry, Milkstone guys, but I would much rather see my score and keep the video a little bit shorter. 1.946 million points. And that was my first completion with Menzi. So now we have unlocked hard mode with him. That is great. That is awesome. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to leave your feedback in the comments below. And if you want to make sure never to miss a video, be sure to follow me on Twitter. Link is in the description and right over here. And otherwise, if you like the video, make sure to like, share, and subscribe. And as for me, I'm Crimson Raven, and I'll see you soon.